Let's get back to the game with West Virginia leading Oklahoma 20-14 early in the second half.
There's West Virginia. 3 for 7 and third down. Oklahoma facing third down. Wilson gets the first down and more. Breaking the sidelines over the 50-40. Wilson turning loose now. The 30-yard line of West Virginia. And there finally is the All-America form of Stanley Wilson. You can hold him down only so long, and he almost broke it for the distance. A first down to the West Virginia 30-yard line.
Jimmy, they came out, and they broke the wishbone to the right and then used motion back to the left going into the boundary, and Wilson just got out and set him down. This is Chet Winters who can block. All right, here we get a good look. I think when Stanley looks at the footage again, if he stays on the sideline, he scores because I thought he had the angle. West Virginia able to finally run him down.
Coming in to help out with Greg McGowan, but it was Steve Newberry, the cornerback, who made the play. Very short gain here on first down, but now Oklahoma threatening here as they've gotten the ball down to West Virginia territory inside the 30-yard line. It'll be spotted on the 28 for a gain of a pair, second down and 8. Barry Switzer continues to fret along the sidelines. His teams have never lost an opening game at Oklahoma. Matter of fact, Oklahoma's lost the last 13 in a row, 9 of them under Switzer. Second down play for Kelly Phelps, the senior quarterback, a great runner, and now developing somewhat as a passer. Gives inside to the fullback, Weldon Ledbetter. Had a great first half, Ledbetter did. And the slant this time carries him down the 25, maybe the 24. Just
Italian,
inside the 25.
Italian folks, Jimmy, make the tackle. Once again, Don Nealon is showing something he did not show all during the spring, going with an even defense of 4-3. That means Folks is in the middle, and they're just lining up, head up with the Oklahoma linemen.
Here's
just to define them.
Third down play. So far, Phelps has hit 5 out of 10 in converting third down plays. 50%, which isn't too bad. Now it's third down. He needs a long 4. Running the option. Has the pitch back early. Won't get it. That was Wilson, and the pitch came very early. And credit the West Virginia defense for getting pressure to Phelps to force the pitch.
And once again, the guy we've talked about all day long, Folks, makes the tackle. The crowd wants Barry Switzer to go for the first down. Thus far, we don't see the field goal kicker, and maybe Barry will try and keep the drive going. He's got about 2.5 yards for the first down.
Fourth down coming up. Boy, what a big play for Oklahoma. David Carter brings the word in from Barry Switzer. Now Switzer, I think, may want... Nope. I thought he was going to ask for a timeout. Yep, he wants it. He's going to want it. So Switzer wants to talk things over. This could be a critical play. For one thing, psychologically, if you don't make it, Irv, just think what a surge that gives to West Virginia again.
Well, there ain't any question about it. And you talk about psychologically near the end of the first half. For those who just have joined us, Oklahoma was receiving a kickoff. 13 seconds left to go. Onside time for West Virginia. They scored on the next play, a pass, Hostetler to Miller, and that's why they have the lead 20-14. The wide side of the field is to the left side. They've had a lot of success with Ledbetter, the fullback. Switzer is talking it over. Galen Hall is upstairs. This is a look at the West Virginia bench. Don Nealon on headsets. One of the guys with him on the sideline is Billy Alton, was the head coach that pointed out at UTEP.
That would be the kicking angle. The ball is well to the right hash marks. The wind is right in the face of the Oklahoma team, so it'd be kicking against the wind, about a 40-yard attempt. So it would be a very tough assignment for Michael Keeling, even if they decided to go for the field goal. But I think they're going to try for the first down.
And the key when you have a short yardage situation is the middle linebacker. We'll keep our eye on Folks, because what happens here, the lineman will get down and submarine and try and uproot things. Folks will try and clean up top. Let's see if they go to Ledbetter. They are breaking the bone to the left.
All right, Ledbetter's the fullback, and here comes the tight end over to the right side. Now here comes Wilson back, and here's the keep outside by Kelly. He's going to have the first down and maybe more. Touchdown by Phelps. Kelly Phelps, a brilliant call. And Oklahoma is back tied in the ball game.
One of the great calls that you'll see by Barry Switzer. They used motion from the left side after changing the tight end. Wilson went in motion to the right. That got some shift and a movement by the West Virginia defense. And Phelps ran the option, found a seam, cut into the end. I've always liked this guy. He's had some injury problems. He can run 4-4. Anytime you have a quarterback running that type of with that type of speed, I should say, Jimmy, you're in serious trouble. Oklahoma can take the lead with this kick.
There's Michael Keeling's kick up in the air, and it is good. And Oklahoma, once more, is in the lead in the game. So the Sooners have come back, and a brilliant, gritty fourth down play by Kelly Phelps, who races in to score, and it's now Sooners 21, the Mountaineers 20. Well, there's another West Virginia player shaken up a bit. That's Dennis Folks, a great linebacker who was injured on the try for the point, but finally recovers his feet. But what a great play this was by Kelly Phelps.
Well, what a call by Barry Switzer. They faked the fullback, come down with the option. Look at this hole as they were able to hold on to the linebacker and secure him, talking about Folks. And Kelly Phelps, who's got the great speed, finds a seam, and it's just a piece of cake. Oklahoma now on top, 21-20. That is a great call by Galen Hall and Barry Switzer.
23-yard run by Phelps. Oklahoma still in the lead. Now here's the kickoff. Taken inside the 5-yard line. Here's Drury up over the 20, 30. Gray got some room. The 40, 45. And on goes Willie Drury over the 45-yard line. And West Virginia comes up with great field position now for Jeff Hostetler.
Boy, do they do a job on special teams. What a block that time by number 33, King. They start close to midfield again. There's the story on the scoring drive as Oklahoma took the lead. But now West Virginia has the football, and they're in great shape with the quarterback Hostetler at the helm.
That's the third time today that Oklahoma's had an 80-yard drive to score. This one went 9 plays. They scored the first time they had it in 6 plays, and then in 13 plays they went 80 yards. Oklahoma leads by a point. Hostetler fakes on the sprint. Here's Hostetler, drills it, and it's caught beautifully around the 40-yard line for a first down. What a brilliant catch that was by Wayne Brown of West Virginia. He's the speedy flanker back, and it's a first and 10, I think.
This is a guy who came on at the end of the year, looked very good in the Peach Bowl. He can run 4-4, can also return a punt for you. The ball was thrown poorly that time by Hostetler. He's been on target most of the day. This case, instead of throwing on the left side, he threw it on the right side. But what an effort by Brown as West Virginia continues to impress.
At the Oklahoma 42, West Virginia goes right back to the aerial attack of Jeff Hostetler. He plundered the Oklahoma defense in the second quarter. Runs the draw play. Got an opening. Up the middle goes Walczak and down to the 36-yard line.
What they're doing, Jim, is taking advantage of the quickness of Oklahoma, particularly Brian. They start that sprint draw out around the tackle, even as far out as the end. They cut it back over the guard. It's very effective. They picked up good yardage. They've only been able to run that play and the draw today.
That was Jackie Shipp who made the stop. Don Nealon's passing attack has performed outstandingly here in the second and now again in the third period. Short hand off the fullback Ron Wolfley, trying to plunge for the first down. The Oklahoma defense is not caught napping. He gets a short game, but he stops short of the chain, so it'll be inside the 35. But the third down call now for Don Nealon. In comes Darryl Miller with the play.
Had a little bit of a scuffle that time. Leg 62 was trapping John Blake. Got the job done, but then they battled a little bit at the end. Kind of shook hands, so they're all right. Third and short. The key here is the linebacker now.
Well, Oklahoma faced a big play on fourth down. Here's a big one for West Virginia. Third and a yard. There goes Rowell, the tight end over the right side. Here's the tailback. Walczak has a first down, I think. Looked like his motion got down the 31-yard line. That will be a first down for West Virginia.
Excellent call. They pulled Scott Barrows on the sprint draw, and it looks like the forward motion. There's Vance Carlson with the signal. West Virginia on the move again.
We're early in the third period. Oklahoma has come back here in the third quarter to regain the lead for Barry Switzer, 21-20. An outstanding fourth down play did it. Now Switzer's team, which is facing a tough schedule this year. 6 more bowl teams coming up, including Southern Cal, Nebraska, and Texas. They have their hands full right at the moment with West Virginia. In the I formation, Walczak and the tailback. Hostetler to Walczak, flips off the side. Fumbles the ball, can't hold it. Boy, Walczak had some room. Might have gotten down for about 6 or 7 yards at least.
He did have some room, as you pointed out. Barrows was pulling and leading, doing a good job. It all goes for naught. Brings up the second and 10. They have gone to the draw in this situation, or faking the draw. Here's an injury for Oklahoma. Number 10, Scott Case, the defensive back, is down. Nealon is watching him intently. If they take him out, got to believe that they'll throw in that area. We'll watch and see if Case has to leave the action.
Brian Hall, a sophomore from Houston, has come on the field. He's the backup for Case. And Case is going to have to go off. So Brian Hall is in at right cornerback. That'll be toward the boundary here. And let's see if Hostetler tries to jump on that spot.
Last time they were in that situation, Hostetler had a half sprint to his right and then threw to Miller on the left side. We'll see if they go with that play again. A lot of times you go back to what's been good for you.
Well, it looks like that Switzer's going to pull off a lineman, bring in a fifth back. So extra defender is back in the backfield looking for the pass. Hostetler rolling down the middle. Got his man open, and it is caught in here beautifully by Beck, and he is scoring. Touchdown. Carlin Beck goes all the way for West Virginia, and the Mountaineers have exploded right back.
That is an excellent call once again by Nealon. He got double coverage on the left side on the wideout, and so they go up the seam to Carlin Beck. Hostetler with that half sprint to the right, which we thought he would do, but I thought he'd go deep to the flanker. Instead to the back coming out, running just a little circle. That's an excellent effort by Beck to get in the end zone.
241 yards for Jeff Hostetler, who has taken over brilliantly now in the absence of the graduated Oliver Luck, and the passing attack of West Virginia is continuing. And is Paul Woodside to try with a point after. Good snap, good kick. And West Virginia now has opened up a six-point lead once more with 8 minutes and 53 seconds to go in quarter number three from Norman, Oklahoma. The home team is stunned at the moment. It's West Virginia 27, Oklahoma 21. Now the fans are getting a little bit restless. Things are not going well here on the reservation with 4:53 to go in the third period. West Virginia leads 27-21. Hostetler on the draw play. Up the middle, tailback Walzak. Stopped around the 33 or 34. That's a pretty good chunk of gain.
They're using that counter draw instead of running off the right side. They're taking advantage of how quick Oklahoma is. Oklahoma just flies with the football. I remember coming down here with Eddie Crowder once running a counter, and that's all you could run against Oklahoma. They were that quick.
Now they brought the big play man in. Darrell Miller has come in. He's flanked out to the short side on the left, the bottom of your screen, number 81. Oklahoma will have to watch him. Now they switch the strong side to the right. Back to the eye. And now they throw toward the screen, thrown out of bounds. That was a smart play by Hostetler because Oklahoma had smelled the screen, and Hostetler just threw it away.
They definitely had smelled the screen, and Hostetler really shows you something, Jim. This is the guy who had to sit out a year after he transferred, played for Joe Paterno at Penn State, had to wait his turn because they had a pretty good football player last year by the name of Oliver Luck. And now, what a beginning he has had. And the Mountaineer fans didn't really know what to expect from this guy. I think they can expect a great deal.
Well, the fans around Holes Apple, Pennsylvania, have known about Jeff Hostetler. Here it is, third down and four for West Virginia. They run the draw. Tailback, and Carlin Beck won't make it. Stop short of the first down. Oklahoma jubilant. The Sooners have dug in to hold them cold. And West Virginia will have to give back the football with 4 minutes to go in the third quarter.
Tom Benson was really something that time as he smelled the draw and got the job done. His mother had some big decisions a year ago, which ball game to go to, because another son played for Oklahoma State. He's graduated. Now Mrs. Benson watches Thomas play.
Well, no one believed West Virginia was for real until they played the Peach Bowl last year. Well, maybe they'll believe it now. Well, win or lose this game, they have played well. Blocked punt by Oklahoma. This could be a touchdown. And it is taken in for a score. Oklahoma makes the big play.
The guy who got it done is number 16, Daryl Sanji. The punter mishandled the football, just wasn't able to get a handle on it. And Sanji just came right from the left side.
Stanberry gets the touchdown. Keith Stanberry grabbed the loose ball, went on in to score. Let's watch it again.
All right, watch how the punt is mishandled by the kicker. Number 16, Sanji, gets the block right there. And then Stanberry picks it up, and Oklahoma lets its defense tie this thing up. They got a chance to take the lead.
27-27, big defensive play by the Sooners. Boy, what an offensive fireworks we've had here today, and this time a big defensive play. And is Michael Keeling to try with the point after. It's blocked and remained tied. Well, West Virginia comes up with a big play, and the score remains deadlocked at 27-27.